I think sperm are an interesting field of study because they're pretty unique cells. They have like a life of their own. They're like little animals, and they're unlike any other cell in the human body. What defines good sperm is a very interesting and philosophical question. We can count them, we can look at how well they move, we can look at their size and shape, but it's far more than that. It's how they interact with the environment that they're trying to get through to fertilize an egg. Now that could be a woman's body, or it could be a dish inside a lab. The biggest risks of sperm quality today are men doing things to their bodies that decreases the amount of sperm or the quality of sperm that they produce. So obvious things are like wearing underpants that are too tight, heating their testicles higher than their testicles should be heated, but also things like smoking. Smoking is bad for sperm production, and also things like poor diet. We know that men who eat a good diet of fruit and vegetables, lots of antioxidants, generally have better sperm than men that don't. So stay off the burgers and keep on the vegetables.
I'd argue probably not so.
It is a concern that's often discussed in the media about whether sperm quality in men is declining, and I think it probably is a little bit, but I don't think it's declining to the point that we should be really concerned. I think there's a much bigger issue that needs to worry us, and that is the general trend of men and women delaying until they are trying to start a family and delaying until they are older. I think if people, both men and women, were to try for families just a few years earlier, then that would be far better for everyone because they would be more successful and they'd be less likely to need infertility treatments such as IVF.